Assalamu alaikum children, welcome to class 9 biology. Children, we are learning chapter number 13, why do we fall ill. In our previous video, we had seen the definitions of health and definition of disease, right? That health, what is health? Health is a complete state of physical, mental and social well-being. And what do you mean by disease? That anything which disturbing the functioning of the organ or organ system, that is called as disease. And disease free means a particular person which do not have any kind of physically disturbance inside, or physically disturbance in any organ or organ system inside his or her body. This was the last topic. Now today we are going to learn about the types of diseases and causes of diseases, that how many types of diseases are there and who cause the diseases. So let's start the class, children. The first of all, types of diseases. So according to the number of days, the last that for how many days a particular disease remain in a patient body or in a person's body, depending on them, diseases are of two types, that is acute diseases and chronic diseases. Name the please remember the names of the diseases. They are called as acute diseases and chronic diseases. So acute diseases, what is the duration? As I told you, they are last for only a very short period of time in a body. They remain for very small period of time in a body, whereas the chronic diseases last for long period of time inside the body. Intensity. So acute diseases having the severe intensity, whereas the chronic diseases are less severe. Effect on health. This is very important, children. So as the acute diseases remain for a very short period of time in the body, they having very short term effect in the body. We can no loss of weight, no tiresome effect, no any kind of any harmful effects inside the body. Why? Because the particular microorganism is remain for a very short period of time inside the body, right? Whereas in comparison to acute diseases, chronic diseases having the very harmful effect on our health, or very harmful effect on the health of a patient body, because a particular microorganism remains for very long period of time in patient body. So we can see drastic long term effect. We can see the loss of weight also, tired at all the time, so many weakness, right? So acute diseases do not harm our body organs so much because they are remain for very short period of time, whereas chronic diseases having the very high and long term effect on the body. Example of acute diseases are common cold, food poisoning, etc. This remains for only 5 days or 3 days inside the body, whereas TB, that is tuberculosis, diabetes, AIDS, cancer, these are the diseases which are remain for very long period of time inside the body and seriously having remaining a very long term drastic effect inside the body. So the person or the patient, those who have the chronic diseases, the patient having the very poor health after the cure of the particular disease also. Now second types of diseases, that are the communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases, or we can say the infectious diseases and non-infectious diseases. So such diseases which are caused by the microorganisms, the diseases which are caused by the microorganisms, they are called as communicable diseases because these diseases can spread from one person to another person. These diseases can spread from an infected person to a healthy person. That is why they are called as communicable diseases. So how communicable diseases can cause and how they are going to spread, children? So we can say that physical communicable diseases can spread by direct or indirect contact. So physical contact with infected person, that is measles, chicken pox, then animal bites, for example rabies, contact with soil like tetanus, sexual contacts like syphilis, AIDS, transplacental transmission, that is AIDS, for example mother to child, and indirect through air, टीबी, कॉमन कोल्ड, न्यूमोनिया थ्रू कंटामिनेटेड फूड एंड वाटर दैट इज हेपेटाइटिस, कोलेरा फॉर फ्रॉम वेक्टर्स एंड कैरियर्स दैट फ्रॉम मस्कीटोज एंड हाउस फ्लाइज, टाइफॉइड, मलेरिया, फिलारियासिस, फॉर्माइट बोन, यूज ऑफ डोर हैंडल्स, नैपकिन्स, यूटेंसिल्स, राइट. सो दीज आर द कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेज विच आर आइदर स्प्रेड डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली. Whereas non-communicable diseases, or we can say the non-infectious diseases, why they named so children? Because they cannot spread from an infected person to healthy person, right? So that is why they are called as non-infectious, or we can say non-communicable. And the second thing here, that these diseases cannot cause by any kind of microorganisms. ये डिजीज़ कोई माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स की वजह से नहीं होते हैं. दे आर कॉज्ड बिकॉज ऑफ द माल फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द ऑर्गन, दैट ऑर्गन फेल्योर वी कैन से. ऑफ इफ द ऑर्गन इनसाइड द बॉडी नॉट वर्किंग प्रॉपरली, फॉर एग्जांपल हार्ट डिजीज़, राइट, देन हाइपोसिक्रेशन ऑफ इंसुलिन दैट इज डायबिटिस मेलिटस, हाइपोसिक्रेशन ऑफ थायरॉइड दैट इज क्रेटिनिज्म इन चिल्ड्रेन, malfunctioning of immune system which is called as allergy, cancer, dietary deficiency diseases. So these all are the diseases which are called as the non-communicable diseases. So children, mainly two types of the diseases, acute disease and chronic diseases. Acute diseases remain for very short period of time inside the body and do not showing any harmful effects on the body, for example common cold, food poisoning, cough, etc. Whereas the chronic diseases are the long duration diseases inside the body and having or releasing a very harmful effect inside the patient body, for example TB, diabetes, AIDS, etc. Now in means of microorganisms, there are two types of diseases, communicable or infectious, non-communicable and non-infectious. All the infectious diseases are caused by the microorganisms which are called as pathogens, and all the non-infectious diseases cannot cause by the microorganisms, but due to the organ failure, due to the genetic disorders, these diseases can occur inside the body.